Hi comic book fans and welcome to another suddenlycomics.com video. So this weekend it's a Thought Bubble comic convention in Harrogate in Yorkshire. I'm going up for the weekend. I'm taking my mobile home, parking up near Harrogate at a park which takes motorhomes. And I'll be attending both days of the Harrogate convention. That's Saturday and Sunday. So over the past few months, I have been acquiring some comics to take up to Thought Bubble to get signed. So I've got a nice stack of comics here that I'm going to take with me. I'm not actually sure whether people are going to be charging for signing or not. I'm hoping not. If I'm being charged for signing, I won't be getting all these signed. I might get one or two signed, but certainly not all of them. So here we go. I'm just going to share with you the comics I'm taking up to Harrogate with me in the hope of getting them signed. First up, we've got an artist called Becky Cloonan. And I've got a few covers by Becky. Here's the first one, really super Wonder Woman cover there, very striking. That's the first one I'm hoping to get signed. I've got a couple of others by Becky, a Batman cover this time, Scott Snyder doing the story, and Becky doing the cover. Great stuff. And finally from Becky, this is from a series from Image called Reaver. I have to say, I think Becky's cover artwork is the best thing about this comic. I wasn't particularly taken with the story or the internal artwork, but Becky did the covers for all, I think there were six of these. This is issue one. And as I say, I think Becky's artwork is the best thing about Reaver. Okay, right. There's another artist there who's called Danny. I've only got one comic, actually. I'm sure I've got some more of her stuff somewhere. But anyway, she did the cover. She did the artwork on one of these Joe Hill books, The Low, Low Woods. So I'm going to take that up to get signed by Danny. Right, next up, Scott is going to be there. Jock is going to be there, the artist. I've got a really beautiful edition of Witches. Jock didn't do the cover to this. This is actually Jeff Lemire. But Jock does the internal artwork on Witches, so I'll be taking that up to get signed by Jock. This is quite a rare comic. I've got part of the standard Witches production, one of my favourite covers from Witches. This is issue five, and I'm going to try and get Jock to sign that. And then finally for Jock, Jock has did this cover artwork for Batman. It's Batman 100, and that is Jock artwork on the cover. So I'm going to see if I can get Jock to sign that. Right, then we've got one of my current favourite comic writers is going to be at, well, two of them actually are going to be at Thought Bubble. The first one is Ram V. Ram V's quite prolific at the moment. So he is writing the current Swamp Thing run, which I believe it was originally going to be a 10 issue series. I believe because it's been so successful, it has now been extended into next year. So here we have Swamp Thing number one by Ram V. And next up, another. So Ram V did a fabulous mini-series. I did a review of it, which I'll put in the link below. It's called The Many Deaths of Lila Starr, one of my favourite comic series this year. And this is a glorious cover. It's a gloss cover. I can't remember which issue. It's issue number three. And here is a variant cover which I love, to issue four of Lila Star. And I'm going to see if I can get Ram V to sign that for me. And then finally, from Ram V, he has also been writing Catwoman. And there is a beautiful cover here. And when I saw Ram V being interviewed, he'd actually got this cover behind him. So he obviously quite likes it too. There we go, absolutely glorious. Right, there is another artist. Well, she's a writer artist actually. It's called Joelle Jones. She wrote Catwoman for a period of time and did some of the artwork. I don't think this cover artwork is hers. Another Catwoman here to get Joelle's to sign. This is Catwoman number one. Right, and Joelle also is responsible for, she did Lady Killer, and in the first series she worked with Jamie Rich, who she's worked with before, to do the first series of Lady Killer. Jamie Rich is also going to be at Thought Bubble, so I'm going to try and get this little copy here from the first run of Lady Killer, signed by Joelle Jones, and get signed by Jamie Rich. The second series of Lady Killer, Joelle did the art and writing, so I'm going to try and get her to sign issue one of the second series of Lady Killer. Right, another artist here is Zoe Thorogood, and we have here an issue of the Department of Truth. I think it's Department of Truth number 9. It's a variant cover by Zoe Thorogood, obviously written by James Tinian, and I think Tinian is also going to be at Thought Bubble, so if I'm lucky, I can hopefully get this signed by both of them. Nice variant cover here by Zoe. And this one, I adore this cover. I think it's really good. And this is from the series Homesick Pilots. Again, the cover here is by Zoe. But actually, the main writer for Homesick Pilots and the main artist, Dan Waters and Casper Wynyard, are also going to be at Thought Bubble, so I may be able to get this one triple signed by the cover artist, the internal artist, and the main writer. So while we're on Homesick Pilots, here we have Homesick Pilots number one, great issue. I've just read it. Again, the writer Dan Waters and the artist Casper Wynyard are both going to be at Thought Bubble. Hopefully, they're sitting next to each other so I can get them both to sign my copy of Homesick Pilots number one. Right, another person who's going to be at Thought Bubble is Kieran Gillen. This is a fabulous cover. Fabulous looking cover to a series called Die. This is Die number one, and I'm hoping to get Kieran Gillen to sign this for me. Really super cover. This is quite a pricey book, actually. And one of the other writers who is going to be at Thought Bubble is Al Ewing. Al Ewing is extremely prolific, he's written loads and loads of stuff. I'm going to be taking this one up. It's Mighty Avengers number one, I think from something like 2013, written by Al Ewing. I'll be asking Al if he will sign that for me. He's also currently writing the current run of Defenders. Now, I've been collecting this series because I'm really enjoying it, and So I've got Defenders number one, Defenders number two, and I like this cover. I'm enjoying this series, actually. It's a bit off the wall, some different characters. So I'm going to see if I can get Al to sign these. And then I've actually got three copies. I've got the main, I think the main cover here. But I've also got a beautiful variant cover with Joe Jusko doing one of his Marvel Masterpieces covers of Namor. And I'm a bit of a collector of Namor, so I've got that one as well. And then there's a third, another variant cover here. So I've got a few there for Al Ewing to sign. Right, finally, the biggest name probably at Thought Bubble this year is James Tynion IV. So what am I taking up? I could take a whole stack, but you know, the guy's going to be busy. So I've made a selection here from my collection of James Tynion stuff. First off, Department of Truth, issue one, variant cover. You can see that. Lovely cover. So Department of Truth, issue one. I'm going to try and get James Tynion to sign that. Jenny Frison variant, I think. Next up, nice one of my, another one of my favourite series, ongoing series. I think it's going to have 10 issues. I think we're on issue 6 or 7. Nice House on the Lake, number one. I've got multiple copies of this, so I'm taking up one of my copies to see if I can get James to sign it. Next, and I've also got a variant cover to Nice House on the Lake, which I'm also going to try and get signed. And then finally for James Tynion, I'm also trying to go and get him to sign the Zoe Thorogood variant on Department of Truth issue 9. And I didn't really collect, I've got some Something is Killing the Children later issues. I didn't collect it early on, but I have got Something is Killing the Children trade paperback, and I'm going to take that up and see if James Tynion will sign that for me. So there we go. That's my selection of comics that I'm taking up to Thought Bubble to try and get signed. While I'm up there, I will do some videoing, and I'll produce maybe one or two videos when I get back about Thought Bubble. If I can get any of the artists to talk to me and perhaps be prepared to do an interview, I'll see if I can do that. We'll see. So looking forward to this weekend. Enough said.